be joined by my partner, the All-American Jimmy Jackson. And Jimmy, your thoughts on what's taking place at Georgetown over the last couple of weeks?
Well, it's an unfortunate situation, not only for the young man involved and the student involved, but also for the program in general. But out of adversity, positive things can happen, and it's galvanizing this Georgetown team to do something special.
We do have a game to play. What are your thoughts on this one? What should we expect to see?
Old school Big East basketball. The 2-3 zone of Syracuse versus the powerful Georgetown team, playing a little bit differently, but this is a game that's going to be won and lost inside the paint.
And I want to apologize, folks. I've been doing Syracuse games for over 20 years. They were always the Orangemen, but they are the Orange. So my apologies as we get ready to start this one, as we take a look at the Jeep starting lineups. How about Buddy Boeheim? His real name is Jackson, but his mom named him Buddy when he was 2, and he's also the son of the head coach, Jim Boeheim. He's coming off a 26-point career high against Georgia Tech. Meanwhile, Mac McClung at 19 against SMU in their win on Saturday. We've got an all-star officiating crew for this one. Mike Stevens, who did the Final Four in the National Championship game this past year, along with John Gaffney and Roger Ayers. Georgetown, Syracuse. Where's Pearl? Where's the beast? He's on the sideline.
He's on the sideline, baby.
And the tip is controlled by the Hoyas. Terrell Allen will bring it up the floor. And you see that patented Syracuse zone defense.
Yeah, a little bit different. Not as long on the wings. You can get into the gaps. You see Allen right there with a nice little pull-up jump shot. And that's how you have to attack the zone, with a via the pick and roll. Get to your spots, make a decision.
Terrell Allen had only 2 points against SMU on Saturday, so he gets off to a good start. As the Orange fire their first jump shot of the game, and that one goes down deep. Well done by Elijah Hughes.
Still hot from that Georgia Tech game, where basically he was the offense early on, finding himself really comfortable from behind the three-point line.
And talking to Patrick Ewing before the game in the Georgetown locker room, he said the main thing that we have to pay attention to is to recognize their shooters. Yurt Seven misses the jam, gets his own rebound, kicks it out. McClung double-teamed on the baseline. They reverse it deep in the corner, and that one goes down for Jamarco Pickett.
And I love the patience that time by the Hoyas. The initial thrust didn't work, but the ball movement, which we've seen from this Georgetown improve over the last 2 games, able to get a nice open look in a quarter for Pickett.
When talking to Jim Boeheim in his locker room before the game, he thinks this Georgetown team is better without Akinjo, because Akinjo is a ball-dominant guard and it moves around a lot better. McClung to the hole. No, gets his own rebound.
I couldn't agree with Boeheim on that. See McClung again. Good seven inside. But, yeah, the ball is moving a lot freer, which allows Georgetown's offense to be a little bit more efficient.
That's what your teammate said about you at Ohio State.
Excuse me?
You wouldn't have been around.
No, no,
the ball would have moved.
I knew it was coming, bro. I knew it was coming.
Hey,
a lot of them dudes won a lot of games. Remember that.
That's right. That one slipping. Boeheim up top. No. Pickett with a rebound. And Allen will push it the other way. Georgetown coming into this game 6-3, 3-2 at home. And another deep jump shot. This time it's Mosley. Jagan Mosley, senior, out of St. Anthony's in New Jersey. And he gives the Hoyas an 8-3 lead.
Well, it's amazing when the confidence level rises on the team. You can just see it in the body language. And this Georgetown team feels, in particular from shooting the ball behind the arc, that every time they square up, face up, and put it up, it's going in. And they've been successful.
Hughes across the lane, pull up 15-footer and pure.
Athlete, soft stroke, not only from distance, but right there from 15 feet. Gus able to rise above his defender and knock it in.
Coming off that 33-point game on Saturday against Georgia Tech, he was 10 of 15 from the field, 6 of 11 from the three-point line. Allen on the fade. So let's take a look at the keys to the game, Jimmy.
Yeah, for Syracuse, 10 is my friend, meaning 10 made three-point shots allows the Syracuse team to be successful in their 5 wins. They average 10 made threes. And also for Georgetown, the patience. We see it early on against the zone defense. Pick and choose your spots, attack it. Don't try to force the situation, move the defense, you'll get high-quality shots.
So strange. Patrick Ewing was recruited by Jim Boeheim when he came out of high school, and he's got his top assistant, Louis Orr, who was a Syracuse legend.
Yeah, no, it's all interconnected, right, in regards to this Big East, and, you know, who's to say what it is about Jim Boeheim that he hasn't accomplished, and Louis Orr, his son and mine, played together AAU back in Ohio.
Here's Hughes, backs it up, runs a pick and roll, crosses over, looking for a shot at all time. Deep jump shot goes down as Joey Girard just drains a three. The freshman, 6'1", from Glen Falls, New York.
I like Girard. I like his demeanor. Young player, but savvy. There's a nice little mental capacity of the game.
Rick 7 off the mark. Weak side rebound goes to Hughes. He'll bring it up the floor. Syracuse, 5-4, 1-1 in the ACC, 1-0 on the road this season. They snapped the three-game losing streak with their win over Georgia Tech. Rick 7, he's fouled, going to the basket. CeeDee Bey with the foul.
In transition, Allen, Rick 7, one of the best running big men in the country.
Some great names have played and coached in this game. That man, Jim Boeheim, is a legend. Close score so far. Pearl.
Talking about a guy that got it done in point guard position.
That's right. I think Sherman Douglas may have been the second greatest alley-oop passer in the history of college basketball.
No. He's the first.
I was thinking of a guy by the name of Irvin Magic Johnson.
He was pretty good, but not from
Greg,
an alley-oop.
Greg Kelser.
Yeah, see, here you go with this Michigan stuff again.
Well, I mean, I can't really talk to you. Jimmy?
What?
I can't say anything. I just paid you a lot of money. About the Michigan-Ohio State thing, please be sensitive
okay.
And be tender.
All right, I'm still going with
I'm
Sherman.
I'm a little banged up. 11-8. Oh, yes. And the orange. Gerard. Hughes guarded by Mosley. Good battle here.
Yep.
Here's a drive. Dolezal gets to the basket. And they are really impressed with this junior from Slovakia.
Yeah, well, you saw right there. He may be slight in frame. 185 pounds. But right there, where he was able to absorb the contact from a bigger Yurt 7 and finish it at the rim.
Yurt 7 with a turnaround jump shot, and it goes down. 11, make that 13-10 Hoyas. Boeheim driving, kicking inside. Dolezal pump fake up and in. Nice strong move for the spelt Marek Dolezal.
Yeah, the spelt, but also the patience that time not to have to force it, knowing that defenders were coming.
McClung. Pure on the 16-footer. Good shooting to start this game from both teams.
Well, also, these both teams are not forcing the issue. They're allowing the offense to dictate the high percentage shots they're ultimately knocking down, and that's what you want to see from your offense if you're coaches of both squads.
Girard drives. He's bumped. Looks like Pickett will be called for the foul.
But here's the point of the zone. Right in the middle is where you want to get the basketball. From there, when you have a playmaker like McClung, now you turn, you square up. Do I have the shot? Make a quick decision. If not, I can dump it down inside. But having him at the free throw line, he may not be as tall, but his playmaking ability and scoring ability allows him to be effective at that spot.
Hughes off the dribble. That one partially blocked, but he knocks it down anyway. Elijah Hughes within the gym range, 8 points to start this game as Syracuse levels it at 15. Allen. And this will go against the Hoyas.
Georgetown second team foul committed by number 12.
And this will go against Allen.
And how about Syracuse kind of weathering the early storm of Georgetown? Being able to get back in this game patiently. Again, the high percentage shots allowing the Syracuse team to have an effect offensively.
Hughes crosses over, hard drive, picks it up. 15 to shoot. They get it back, reloading. James Harden step back. And a foul. Now let's take a look at the real second greatest alley-oop passer in the history of the game of college basketball. There he is. Sherman Douglas.
Come on.
Man right there.
I'm bringing him over here and tell him
you
said the second. Yeah.
And he's a D.C. legend, Spingarn High School. And he's not even the most famous D.C. guy to go to Syracuse. You know that would be the Bingo. Dave Bing. 50 yep. greatest.
And there's so much history with both of these programs in regards to players who were able to wear the you know, don the uniform and actually coming out
Didn't
of high
you
school.
Recruited by Syracuse?
Coming out of high school, Kenny Anderson and I, this was our number one choice to go to school. I came and took a visit though at Syracuse in November, December. I was like, man, I can't do it.
Too cold.
But Georgetown also was on that list because at the time, the Big East is where basketball was at.
Did you visit Georgetown?
I did not take my visit to Georgetown. I, you know, ended up, of course, committed to Ohio State. But I always think about what if I would have played in the Big East at one of these universities, what the legacy could have been. But I just grew up a Big East fan.
Coach Boeheim said this when 35,000 showed up at the Carrier Dome for the final Big East meeting between these two teams in 2013. Coach Boeheim said at one time for a 10 to 15 year period, this was probably the number one rivalry in the country. McClung, short. Girard pulls it down. Boeheim, quick release. And out of bounds. Let's go back to 1965-66. Jim Boeheim was on this Syracuse team, but look at his teammate. Bingo! Dave Bing. And the greatest thing about Mayor Bing is that he was the mayor of the greatest city in the world.
Here we go.
Detroit.
Here we go. I mean, we just cannot get off of this right now. You know we're doing the Georgetown-Syracuse game.
Okay,
you know that, right?
You got it. You're set.
We're Big East country.
That's right.
Okay. Just saying.
Dave Bing and Coach Boeheim, roommates at Syracuse. Now Hughes on the spin. Allen, fight for the rebound. Hard push into the front court. And a foul. Looks like a blocking foul called against Girard.
Right, that was great defense by Jagan Mosley on the last Syracuse possession. Now, talking to Patrick Ewing about how to slow down Elijah Hughes, he said, listen, we're not going to double team. We're going to hedge to his side a little bit, but a straight up man-to-man and force Elijah Hughes to have to shoot over defenders. And that time, Mosey did an excellent job.
I had a chance to get on Coach Ewing's radio show this week. And folks, I covered Patrick Ewing for about 15 years when I was the voice of the New York Knicks. And for the beast, as we call him, he's affectionately called, to have a radio show would be unheard of, guys. Mosley knocks down a three.
Yeah, because Pat wasn't the interview type. He'd give you what he needed, and he was done with it. But now, on the other side of the ledger, being a coach, a little bit different.
Girard in and out. Good seven with the board. Mosley on the crossover, the kick. Allen. Boom. Make that Javon Blair. Blair tied his career high with 21 points on 7 of 11 shooting. All his shots were threes in 18 minutes off the bench against SMU. Dolezal picks it up in no man's land.
Great help by McClung right there on Hughes.
Boeheim looking for a shot. And the rebound to Blair. C.D. Bay couldn't convert. Blair again. Short this time. Rebound. Yurt 7. Can't finish. At close range. 21-16 Oyers. Here's a lob. Dolezal. Good.
Way to gather. I mean, that side, that time, Dolezal a little caught behind the basket, but excellent footwork and also showing a soft touch right there on the baseline with a little jump up.
Dolezal with 6 points to start this game. 21-18, 11 minutes to play. in the first half. Syracuse, Georgetown. With seven in the high post. Georgetown doing a nice job moving the ball. Mosley frees himself. And foul. Looks like Boeheim gets it.
Well, Gus, this Georgetown offense is operating on all cylinders. Seven made baskets off of seven assists. When you do that, you find yourself open, and all you got to do is step up and knock it inside. And once you get the defense running at you, pump fake, get a foul, get to the free throw line.
Close game here in the first half. Patrick Ewing's team very well prepared. 21-18. Hoyas on top of the Orange. Fox College Hoops is sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. 21-18. Georgetown leading Syracuse here in the first half. Let's go inside the huddle with Patrick Ewing.
Finish. We got to finish. Hey, look. Hey. When he gets that down there, don't just stand like that. Whoever that was. Don't just, I'm talking about the big kid. When he got it.
So listen, we got three chairs.
One off. He goes up to shoot. He ain't going to block it, but I'm just saying, jump. Make it look crowded. Oh, man, you got.
Well, I like what Patrick is saying. You're not going to block the shot, but you want to contest the shot and make it more difficult. I think it was Dolezal who had the shot inside of what he was talking about. So that's his great wall-up defense inside. And if he makes the shot, he makes it. But give him a hard contest.
Jacob Mosley at the line shooting three. He's got 6 points, four assists. His career high in assists is eight.
You know, one thing, Gus, about you now, you lose three players, so you shrink your bench and your roster to four players. What happens, though, is what we're seeing with this Georgetown team is that now, guys, the players are more comfortable in their space. They know how many minutes. They know what they're going to do on the court. So it's a comfort level now with the 7-8-man rotation. And that's why, ultimately, this team, Georgetown team, is playing much more efficiently right now.
I wonder why it took Patrick so long to figure that out. Jim Boeheim has been playing seven for 44 years.
Man, Elijah Hughes coming off that 33-point effort against Georgia Tech, and right now he's showing the skill set, 3-for-4 from behind. I mean, from the field, 9 points, but a beautiful soft shooting stroke. Highly athletic. This young man is on pace right now. He averages 4 assists, 1 steal, 1 block, 40% behind the 3-point line. He does that all season. Only Markel Fultz and Joe Spence have done that for a season.
George Mirasan shot. Off the mark, and here come the Orange. Howard Washington inside as they find Quincy Guerrier. And that one waved off. Second foul on Guerrier.
And if you heard the name Mirasan, yes. That's the son of former NBA player, Washington Wizards player. At the time of the bullet.
George Mirasan.
George Mirasan. Not as big as Pops.
Nope. 23-18 Hoyas. McClung contested. Got it. Largest lead of the game for the Hoyas.
Well, I love the quick decisions once again. The ball is not sticking on the offensive end for the Hoyas, which is allowing them to get the open looks, in particular from behind the three-point line.
Dolezal on the baseline working. Passed it up and banked it down. This kid is very talented.
And that time, Mirasan did exactly what Ewing wanted him to do, or his players to do, which is wall up. But Dolezal, once again, showing a unique skill set to be able to get it up through contact and finish.
He's got 8 points, averages 9 a game on the season.
Gus, you know, sometimes you can play great defense. Okay, Mirasan here cuts off the baseline, wall straight up, but Dolezal right here. Tricky, shows off the soft touch off the glass, and that's why Coach Boeheim and the coaching staff are so high on this young man.
He's been in double figures in three straight games, and season high 19 against Seattle. Averaged 4 points a game last year. As Allen goes to the line with 4 points. Terrell Allen from Upper Marlboro, Maryland. has started the last two games since Akinjo and LeBlanc.
Another Kamatha High graduate. Happy to be back at home. And how things happen in situations sometimes, you come over from UCF. Now you're starting, you know, Georgetown, a program that you followed when you were growing up in high school. He's doing an excellent job of controlling tempo, distributing the basketball for this Hoyas team.
7-point game. 9-11 to play in the first half. Hughes got a quick trigger. Gerard, DJ, got it.
See the ball fake? The ball fake froze Matt McClung. That allowed Gerard to kind of, Gerard to square up his shoulder. What a beautiful stroke he has.
Inside. Here's the wheel and the kick. And looks like a 3-second violation against Georgetown.
Yeah, go back to Gerard playing. Nice dribble penetration. McClung right here. Actually, he freezes not only McClung, but Javon Blair right there. Because he has to get back inside, and that allowed Gerard to just stroke a beautiful jump shot.
Now Washington. Go to Jai. To the hole. Block. Wahab picked up. Mosley. Blair D. Wahab, nice offensive rebound. And a new shot clock for Georgetown.
Yeah. An area of concern for the Orange.
And McClung fouled on the sideline by Dolezal. And now a technical foul. Looks like we'll go against the Syracuse bench.
When we first get Dolezal, looked like he's in a good position right there. I can understand his frustration of not getting. I think it may have been his lower body when he inched up into McClung. I don't know. I thought that was pretty good defense that time by Dolezal.
So that technical foul looks like called on Coach Boeheim.
Or was it on the bench for being up? Because it looked like it might have been the official went and said something to the bench.
Dolezal picks up his first foul. 75-year-old Jim Boeheim, he's in incredible shape. Does Pilates three times a week. He's trying to get me to do the Pilates thing, Jim.
Well, I'll try to get you to do the Pilates thing. So you forget about your boy.
Yeah, but you're not 75.
But I'm a model of consistency over here. At 49, you know, to
49.
Still be able to get around and do what I do.
Next year, you officially will be an old man.
Yeah, officially.
Here's McClung. Having a great start to his career at Georgetown in his sophomore season. Heads out of the game. He has 8 points. Allen back in.
And it's so much growth in McClung's game. Understanding time to score, not to take the difficult shots, not to make it harder on yourself, but also not to put your teammates in difficult situations by forcing the issue. But that comes just with maturity.
And Washington throws it out of bounds. Fourth turnover for Syracuse.
A little miscommunication that time between Gerard and Washington. Again, you don't want to give this Georgetown team ample opportunities offensively because of how efficient they've been thus far in the first half. You don't want to beat yourself.
Good seven. Quick turn on the baseline, and he traveled. 7:53 to play in the first half. Hoyas up 30-23 over the Orange. Back to D.C. right after this.
He's going to be back dunking very soon. We know Big John is probably watching right now. We want to wish him a great recovery. We hope he gets back to watching these games very soon.
And you know who's the happiest about Big John being out of the hospital? The nurses. I heard he was wreaking havoc with those poor ladies.
Yeah.
Coach, come on. But well, we wish you well, big fella.
We
can't
do.
Wait to see you. We'll be here soon.
Hey, guys, can you imagine them trying to get him to do something
gosh.
That he doesn't want to do?
Oh, my gosh. He's probably telling the doctors what they need to do.
What? No, yeah, I'm fine. Get me out of here.
He would be impressed with the way His Warriors are playing right now. Baseline, Dolezal. Dolezal, nice around the basket, 10 points already.
Yeah, that time Elijah Hughes was able to track a lot of attention that got Dolezal open on the baseline.
How do you break this Syracuse zone?
Patience. It has to touch the baseline right there. That skip pass is opened in the middle. You're able to get some shots. Good recovery that time by the Orange to get back.
And a whistle. Offensive foul called against Georgetown's good seven.
Well, behind the arc. I mean, the three-point shooting right now for Georgetown has been spot on, 5 for 8, but a lot of it's coming off the second, third, fourth pass, which that's how you break down the zone defense. The initial thrust, you're not going to get. Interior passing, baseline passing opens it up for three-point opportunity.
7 minutes to play. Washington across the lane. The teardrop goes down.
Nice curl that time by Washington in the teeth of the defense.
Howard Washington, 6'3", from Buffalo. Missed most of last season after suffering a stroke.
And he said that really changed his perspective on life, Gus, and enjoying the moment a lot more, not taking things as seriously.
McClung, quick release. Loose ball. Bodies on the floor. Nice job by Mosley. Inside, you're at 7. And he traveled. 6 turnovers against the Hoyas.
Yeah, and that's, you know, one thing. But give Syracuse a lot of credit, because it seemed to be a 3-on-1, but the hustles to get back defensively to get right in front of your 7 caused the turnover. So you don't give up on the play even though you turn it over, or you're not able to get it. So excellent defense.
Hughes. Bumped. Keeps his dribble alive. Approaching the 6-minute mark of the first half. Hughes spinning. James Harden. We just might as well call that step back one-legged. The Harden.
How about the Hughes knew exactly where he wanted to get to on a smaller island, so he used his dribble and his body to inch his way right to about 15 feet so he can rise right over the top.
McClung off the bounce and foul. Edwards gets it.
Elijah Hughes, the 6'6 junior, understanding he has the size advantage, but patience. Get myself close to the lane. Now I'm able to raise up on that step back. You talked about it. The Harden right here, step back, clear some space, splash.
You know why he's doing so well. It's the shoes. It must be the shoes.
Come on, bro. You got to look good while you're doing it.
Nice. McClung. Mac McClung. Two of his best three games of the year have come in the last two outings. 33 on 12 of 21 against Oklahoma State and 19 versus SMU.
And how about the, I think it was seven for seven from the free throw line against SMU. So, again, kind of honing his game to be a lot more efficient.
Hughes, a 3. Oh, this kid is on fire. 14 in the first half.
Hold that game. And he has game. He can beat you off the bounce. Right there, that's off the dribble, deep three-point shot. So it's a challenge when you have to guard a player that's multi-dimensional.
And a foul coming up as Allen drives.
And sometimes, Gus, you know when you got it going good. You know, Mosley right in his face, cuts him off, but the crossover, right back into a rhythm dribble. Watch the quick move down, cross back, square up, three ball.
And we talked about Elijah's cool sneakers. Different story though for Mac McClung.
What is like, that?
What is that?
He spat it?
Huh?
Is he spat it right
he looks
there?
Looks like he's.
He spat it. It must say something.
Has he got
on there.
Tape on it? Look at that. And look at
look that.
What's going on at Georgetown?
Hey man.
Tape on it and everything.
We got to talk to an equipment manager right there and what's going on. But you know how it is when you hoop. If you look good, you like you play,
play
better.
Good. You know but what you mean? Know what? They say Kevin Durant will play with the same sneakers the whole season.
No. No way. Impossible. Impossible. I used to change mine every couple games, maybe.
Hughes again. This time he works inside. He's got 16.
And the Syracuse offense does a good job of positioning Hughes in different spots on the court to allow him to be effective. That time mid-post.
34 up. Your seventh block and taken away. Nicely done by C.D. Bay. Here comes Hughes. Heat check. Loose. And a whistle and foul on the baseline. Dolezal digging that rebound out.
Well, your seven inside. C.D. Bay right there, able to go straight up and down and block it. But again, mid-post. Okay. Not fully committed that time by Jamarco Pickett to step in, allowed Hughes to go for the shot.
Pickett picks up his third. Hughes again on the fadeaway. Short this time, with seven clears it. Georgetown pushing, McClung, and he's fouled on the sideline. Dolezal picks up his second. Matt McClung will go to the line. Those must be lucky sneakers or something.
Mm-hmm. Syracuse. Start rolling. You just kept them.
They are beat up. Well, with Akinjo leaving, would you say that this is Mac McClung's team at this point?
I would, from a talent perspective. He's going to be their go-to guy in regards to scoring the ball. I don't know if he's the voice in that regard, because some guys lead a little bit differently. If you look at where it's going, Terrell Allen, really, from a leadership perspective, because of his maturity, kind of been through the experience-wise, is probably the natural leader, but he's quiet as well.
McClung with a rebound, takes a three in transition. Yip 7 kept it alive, but a foul over the back on Omer Yip 7. His second. But what a start for Elijah Hughes. 16 points here in the first half. 36-34. Two-point game, Georgetown and the Orange.
They will move up in their top spot.
I like Wesson. Wesson lost a lot of weight during the offseason. Looks like he lost about 20 pounds.
He did. But putting his name in the draft protocol in regards to getting a true evaluation of what the big boys in the association thought, it was the quickness, the ability to guard off the pick and roll, endurance, and you had to do that by honing your body and dropping some weight. And he dedicated himself, and now he's playing the best basketball of his career.
Hughes playing some great basketball in this game with 16, another jumper. It goes down, but they wave it off. Offensive foul against Syracuse. He got a screen.
Well, let's take a look here. He's able to get it. Dolezal right there. I think that was Mosey right there that ran pretty much into
Dolezal
right there. That's probably the second questionable call for him. And that's his third foul. Taking another look right here. Dolezal, well, does he turn his hip a little bit? Yes. I think that could have been a play on situation right there. Well, he does move right there at the end. Okay,
and it
on
is
that
a
angle.
Reviewable play.
Yep.
So they'll take a look at the monitor.
Yeah, I think it was at the end right there, Gus, when he moved up a little bit, that took the angle away from Mosey to get around the pick.
And the foul will stand on Dolezal, his third. He goes to the bench. Two-point game. Allen, Mosley, McClung. Wahab inside, along with Murison. Mosley, another jump shot. For Jacob Mosley, who has 11 points in the first half.
Well, just that tiny penetration by Terrell Allen to suck the defense in, that gave Mosley enough space to circle around, square up, and had a free look at a three-point shot.
Hughes strip. Allen to McClung. Straight to the hole. Double clock block, but goaltender.
14 for McClung in the first half.
And little thing, Allen gives it up at the right time, allows McClung to do his thing in transition, and Hughes on the backside. A little late to the party. Georgetown rolling.
And Elijah Hughes putting on a show. Hughes with 16, McClung with 14. And Jimmy, even last year when I saw the kid for the first time, I just looked at his game, and the first name that came to mind was Mark Price.
And what reminded you so much of Mark Price in his game?
Jump shot, pretty pure, great handle of the basketball, can go anywhere he wants, and knows how to play. Blocked by Mosley. That's outlet pass. Allen. Pull up Jay. Wahab trying to hold on, out of bounds, and will stay right here.
All right, speaking of Mark Price, too, in the comparison you talked about, McClung shoots 94% from the free throw line, very similar to what Mark Price has done. McClung is not shooting the ball well in the first half, but he is right now from the free throw line, 7 of 8. So that balances you off if you're not shooting from the, you know, from the perimeter pretty well, not from the field goal perspective. So that's the balance you talk about in the game that you want to have.
McClung has got deep range. If he can get set, Mirasan. Guerrier in the corner. He'll set. Mosley doing a little bit of everything, scoring and rebounding in this first half. Hoya's up 41-34. Syracuse back in the zone as usual. Georgetown on a 7-0 run. Since the score was 34 apiece. Wahab, block. Gets it back. Back door, McClung, left hand. Mac Daddy, 16 points.
And it shows off that athletic ability right there. Instead of standing still, made the right decision to make a cut down back door.
Buddy Boeheim, no. Wahab with the board. Georgetown really doing it on both ends now. Back to Ewing's team. Well prepared for Syracuse. McClung again on the baseline. Frees himself. Almost threw it out of bounds. Pull up Jay. Mid-range, in and out. Mears out with the rebound. New shot clock for Georgetown as we approach a minute remaining in the first half. Allen almost lost it, shovels it out, and a turnover for Georgetown. There's 7.
As we go back to this, nice cut. See, reminds you of Mark Price, but Mark Price wasn't doing things like this. That athletic ability allows him to be creative inside and actually initiate the contact and finish.
Girard. Boeheim 0 for 5 to start this game. Knocked away McClung with a steal. Mac McClung to the hole, and it's in.
And he knew it. Once he had the steal, he knew Girard couldn't do anything with him in transition. He was patient and went right over the top.
And listen to this Georgetown crowd. McClung, 18 points. Georgetown on an 11-0 run. Shot clock turns off. Game clock at 10. Hughes pulls up and hits. Elijah Hughes, 5 seconds. McClung, will he give it up? Will he take it? He lets it fly. Pure! Mac Daddy! 21 in the first half. Georgetown ends on a furious run as the Hoyas close on a 14-2 run to take a 48-36 lead at the break.
Well, you ask if it's whose team is it from a physical scoring perspective. Is Matt McClung right there in transition, and you knew what he was going to do right here. Eyeing it up, squaring it up. If it's free, it's for me. Give me 3. Right before the half, you talk about carrying momentum for Georgetown. This is how you want to end the half. Put a dagger right in the heart of the defense.
Let's join Andy Katz, who's standing by with Patrick Ewing.
All right, thank you, Gus. Well, Patrick, how would you describe Mac McClung's first half?
That's great. We need for him to be great. He's had three spectacular games for us, and we need for him to continue to do that. I didn't like one of the shots he took, but the last one was, time was running out, it was a great shot. We need him for him to, one of the things I loved about him is his swag and his heart, and he's showing that. Now we need for him to continue to do that.
What are you gonna tell your team in the second half of how they gotta better defend Elijah Hughes?
We can't stop, he's a great player. I mean, he's making tough shots. You have to keep, continue to make him take tough shots. When he missed, we have to come up with that rebound.
Thanks, Patrick.
Thank you.
Back to you, Gus.
Patrick didn't like one of the shots McClung took, but he played with John Starks for many, many, many years. He's used to it. McClung scored the last 9 points for the Hoyas. Georgetown doing it on both ends. Coach Boeheim has to make some adjustments. 48-36 at the break. We'll send you to Mike Hill in L.A. for the Jeep Grand Cherokee. Halftime report right after this. Let's take a look at the Jeep first half stats.
Well, if you look at what Syracuse has done right now, shooting 50%, but they haven't been able to get to the free throw line. Only 1-for-3 as compared to Georgetown, 15 of 19. So doing an excellent job.
And I talked to Mac McClung at halftime about these shoes. He says, hey, man, these are my Jordans. If I don't wear them, I lose my juice.
You know,
you know what juice is. What's juice?
That juice is something that you feel. Shoes do something for you. It's something when you put them on that you feel comfortable in them and you want to continue to wear them, especially when you're playing well. It's almost like a superstition. And plus, you gotta have a nice pair of J's at all times. You always gotta have some J's.
Dolajai missing his first shot of the second half. Georgetown will take over. McClung with 21 in the first half. Looks down low. Pickett to Allen. Quick release. No. Gets it again. Teardrop rolls down.
But another offensive rebound that time by the Hoyas. That's one thing that Syracuse wanted to guard against. You're talking about 10 offensive rebounds for 10 points for the Hoyas.
Largest lead of the game for Georgetown, and considering what the team has been through, it's a very, very good performance so far.
I give these young men credit for staying focused and committed to the process. You see outstanding defense, and a lot of times when you go through some adversity, it's tough to kind of figure out how to move forward, where you use the game of basketball to do that, and this team has joined together.
Boeheim picks up his third. No points for Buddy Boeheim. Remember, he's coming off that big 26-point career high against Georgia Tech on Saturday.
You have to find a way to get him involved in the offense, and sometimes, Gus, is just as little as getting himself to the free throw line to feel a little rhythm, which could then spur maybe 2 or 3 field goals in a row.
Pickett. Drive the other way. He's got Hughes with him. Hughes had the hot hand. Drives to the hole. Finger roll. And a foul on the floor coming up.
And I like that quick up the pace, up the floor by Syracuse. The Georgetown defense was not yet set. Hughes was able to pick up a foul, but it's going to be interesting to see the adjustment that the Orange make in regard to their zone offense. Talking to Red Archer before the game, they want to compact it a little bit more to take away and protect the lane. As a result, Georgetown was able to spread the ball around a little bit more and be effective from behind the three-point line to the tune of 7-13.
Buddy Boeheim will inbound the ball with Dolajai, C.D. Bay, Gerard. Here's Gerard for three. And good.
Beautiful play. Underneath out of bounds. A couple curl screens, down screens. Gerard that time very patient to allow the play to work. And then at the last moment, able to curl, square his body up, and knock in that three.
Plum. As they reverse it, baseline. Jacob Mosley drives. Almost coughed it up and does cough it up as Hughes takes over.
Great defense that time, interiors wise by the Orange.
Wow, Gerard. Long jump shot for Joey Gerard.
You should have saw Jim Payne. His face is like, what are you doing? Being a freshman, man, you think you're invincible. Make anything.
And a foul coming up. We'll send you at 7 to the line.
Excellent play. Let's go back to the play right here where Gerard is going to go inside and then utilize it to get to a spot. But again, it's all about being patient, allowing the play. And Matt McClung that time got kind of stuck and lost, was watching the ball. Gerard Spartley was able to get outside and knock it in.
Hughes picks up his first. Georgetown, this is their 10th trip to the free throw line. They're 15 of 19. One goes down. Syracuse only one trip to the line, one of three. The last 12 and a half minutes of the first half, Georgetown shot 15 free throws, Syracuse none.
I think that's excellent defense. This is an aggressive Georgetown defense, but if you can utilize your size and quickness, put your opposing team in a predicament without fouling, now the defense holds serve on that end of the court.
Homer, you're at seven, Turkish International. Inside, CD Bay, the kick, Hughes.
You know, that one, I like to see CD Bay kind of challenge Yurt Seven right there inside because he had great post-up position. Maybe he didn't feel comfortable or confident that he could finish up over the top.
McClung, top of the arc. With the Mac. McClung.
Did the net move?
Did it move? It did not.
And that's over a contested hand, too. Yes. Off the dribble going right for a right-handed player to square his shoulders and knock it in.
Boeheim with a good look, and he finally gets one to fall. Buddy Boeheim's first basket of the day. 55-42.
And Boeheim, you just have to stay with it. You're going to get opportunities. Just when you have it, don't think about it and let it fly like this.
That one a brick. Gerard. Boeheim ahead of the field. Gerard, hesitation on the wheel. Lost it on the way up out of bounds. And it'll be Georgetown basketball.
Watch this. Now, you're going right with a right-hand player. It's a little bit tougher to get that body turned and square. But because he's so low to the ground, watch the explosion up and in. And the Nets barely move.
Allen turns the corner. Feeds Mosley deep. Dolajay brings it up himself. Gerard shows it, leans, and hits.
Wow. Prime example, we always say great D, better O.
Jay Gerard starting to heat up. He scored 24, including 5 of 6 on threes in his first collegiate start versus Seattle. And an offensive foul called against the Warriors.
And Joe Gerard being creative off the bounce. This patience, able to get a two inside. Georgetown 55 on 11. I always defer to this, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. And you know why?
Numbers why?
No. 4 state championships in high school, 3 in college, 6 in the NBA, multiple MVPs, all-time leading scorer. When you talk about winning basketball and a person that done it at each level, you don't get better than Kareem. Now, again, I grew up watching Michael Jordan, Magic. Michael was right there. But when you talk about overall, he's the greatest that ever done it. It's hard to argue with that.
You have a point. You may be right. Gerard trying to be great here in the second half.
And you would say?
I would say. Jimmy Jackson.
My man.
Then lob, baseline, McClung goes up high, has it knocked out of his hands. Yurt Seven picks it up. Gerard hits the deck and gathers the loose ball. One thing about Mac McClung, he can rise.
He can rise. That time, good position. CD Bay right there inside. Let's see if Syracuse can put on a little run here. I mean, offensively, get a couple buckets, but you got to get multiple stops at the defensive end.
Quick. Pass to Gerard. And over the back coming up on CD Bay. His second.
Good look that time by Gerard. Great box out inside. I think that was DeMarco Pickett.
McClung, baseline, Mosley. With seven calling for it inside. Now Pickett, a 15-footer. With seven, got a hand on it, gets a rebound, muscles his way up, missed it, but tapped up and in. DeMarco Pickett. Georgetown using their length on the board.
Well, they are. I tell you what, in that time, it was excellent. Excellent read that time by Yurtseven to kind of seal himself inside underneath the defender to be able to keep multiple offensive rebounds alive.
Here's Elijah Hughes. He's gone cool over the last few trips. Boeheim in the corner. Gerard against sets. And good. Joey Gerard starting to bring this Syracuse team back. Remember, he's New York State's all-time leading scorer for a high school player. 4,763 points. McClung. Pickett almost double dribble. Now Allen. McClung for three. Dolezal brings it up the floor. He's got Boeheim with him. Dolezal to the hole and a foul. Let's take a look at the top four high school basketball scores in New York State all time.
Wow, you see Joe Gerard right there. How about my man, Lance Stevenson, Miles Brown, Ryan Creighton? I mean, you're putting up, you're talking about in New York, but you're putting up some numbers. 29, 29, and here's the man that leads it all right here. I think he's going to have a fabulous career here at Syracuse, only scratching the surface, I think, of how good he can be offensively, but what kind of leader he can be as well.
Dolezal. ...57-48. Largest lead for Georgetown, 16. Blair, a three. That's a brick, loose. Here comes Hughes in transition. Dolezal, the trailer, stops. Swings it. Gerard, he's been hot, 15-footer. That one halfway down, popping out.
Yeah, and that time, the Orange did everything right on that offensive set. The ball just didn't go in. They got the shot that they wanted.
Baseline, Mosley.
Got him.
Mosley has had a fine game, 14 points now. And Georgetown takes a 60-48 lead. Mosley also has 6 rebounds and 4 assists.
Talking about somebody benefiting right now from more PT and really expanding his game. That's Jagan Mosley.
Dolezal, the runner inside, in and out. Ten turnovers for Georgetown. Under 12 to play. 60-48. Boy. Syracuse Capital, 60-48. The Hoyas looking for their 7th win of the season against Syracuse. Learn how the American Cancer Society is teaming up with coaches at coachesversuscancer.com. Offensive rebounds in this game a factor. Georgetown out-rebounding Syracuse on the offensive glass, 12-2. Second chance points, Georgetown 12, Syracuse
0.
Well, as a result, too, when you get the ball in the middle of the paint against the zone defense, it then turns to almost a man-to-man, and that's where Georgetown has the advantage on the backside. When the shot goes up on the rim, they're able to embed themselves inside and get the offensive rebound.
Boeheim. Buddy Boeheim, back-to-back threes. He has 6 now after going scoreless in the first half. 2 for 7 from the field. And a foul over the back. Edwards for Syracuse.
And patience, we talked about, finally will open up for Buddy Boeheim. Able to slip to the outside. A lot of attention again paid to Elijah Hughes. And that time, Terrell Allen kind of caught in between. Allowed Buddy Boeheim to square up and knock it in.
Talking to Coach Boeheim in the locker room before the game, he said the thing that we have to work on, and it's going to take time, is just we're kind of young and a little, not frail, but not as strong as we could be. And we will be down the road.
Yeah, comfort youth, but not the same athletes that we've seen in the past, but a lot of very smart, intelligent players.
3 to shoot, and Jagan Mosley with the jump shot that goes in. 16 points for Jagan Mosley. Georgetown up by 11. Here's Boeheim on the curl at the elbow, and he knocks one down.
Let's see what happens when you finally see the ball go in. Now the rhythm is a little different. He has more of a pep in his step right now instead of selling for a 3. Nice, tight curl.
Pickett, high arcer, short. Hughes snatches it. Boeheim, 3. And the possession arrow favors Georgetown.
Yeah, sometimes it happens, baby. Get it out, jump ball, and Jagan Mosley right here, a little jab step inside runner. High degree difficulty of shot that's on the move, but he knew the shot clock was going down, had to put it up.
Approaching the 10-minute mark of the second half. Georgetown coming off a win against SMU. Syracuse coming off a win against Georgia Tech. Allen inside. He picked it up and nobody guarded him.
No, that time, but again, it's that penetration into the teeth of the defense. That time, lack of communication by the Orange.
Allen with 11. McClung back in the game. And here comes Mack McClung. At 21 in the first half. Baseline, you're 7. Beautiful, and good.
Beautiful.
66-53, Georgetown clicking on all cylinders.
Find yourself on the baseline, nice little touch, jump shot, you're 7. Give me those 2.
Saturday in a huge game usually reserved for tourney time. We've got second-ranked Kansas facing number 20 Villanova. All the action tips off at 11:30 Eastern. Only on Fox and the Fox Sports app. Our score, 66-53, Georgetown. And Georgetown finding a way to conquer this Syracuse zone.
Well, it's right here, but it came off of ball movement, and that's how you attack. And Jesse Edwards actually is in great defensive position. You're 7 slides behind, not fully committing up to Allen, allows him to step back a little bit. Get that jump shot off, but you attack the zone, Gus, when you move it side to side. When the gap opens, either via the pass or the dribble, get yourself in the middle of the court.
Patrick Ewing's team, very disciplined today. You can see that he prepared them extremely well for this game. The Syracuse zone is a hard zone to figure out.
It is. I mean, but again, if you can get to gaps, it then turns to almost like a one-on-one guarding situation, but it's not going to happen in the initial thrust, and Georgetown has been very patient this afternoon.
There's a lob inside, up and in. Dolaje again, who has 13 now.
And a great misdirection play. It sucked the Georgetown defense into the lane, which allowed Dolaje to get an easy look at the basket on the baseline.
McClung quiet. since coming back in. Pickett drives to the basket. No. Wanted a call. Won't get it. Gerard, he's been hot in the second half. Straightaway three. Tipped by Pickett. Jagan Mosley. Crosstown, midtown. Rush hour traffic. Pickett. Pickett finding himself wide open.
Yeah, in transition, but you know all the time, if you don't communicate, that drag man is going to be open. That time, Pickett not able to capitalize.
Hughes with a tough second half so far, but that one tipped up and in by C.D. Bay.
The quick attack, Gus. Georgetown wasn't settled in, and C.D. Bay able to maneuver himself inside to get that offensive rebound and score.
Georgetown is led by as many as 16. Blair, the left-handed three. Good. That's a big shot.
It's a big shot, but again, it's the triple penetration in the teeth of the defense. You collapse it, and now Blair being patient, Gus, not encroaching upon the space, able to get that three.
Hughes has gone cold. Blair, McClung, spinning, stripped out of bounds, and will stay down here.
Gus, when it's going good from behind the arc, you feel you're not going to miss anything. Blair able to step up, knock him another three-point shot for the Hoyas.
Georgetown with the lead. Jimmy, let's update your keys.
Well, 10 is my friend, and right now Syracuse is sitting at 9 3-pointers, but haven't been able to stop this Georgetown offense. And patience is what I said about Georgetown. And talking about somebody with patience, biding his time, now Jagan Mosley is able to exploit the opportunity of being on the court. And he's much freer in his offensive attack, whether that's inside or out, taking advantage of a situation that calls on the senior right now, stepping up big time.
Jagan Mosley not only turned out to be a terrific basketball player for Georgetown, he's in his senior season. He's also a finance major as Blair hits another three. Georgetown 11 of 21. Remember, they hit 14 threes at SMU in their win. And they're continuing to have the hot hand from behind the three-point line.
Man, how times have changed. You remember Georgetown being it's always around centers and put the ball in the paint, and right now finding the niche like a lot of teams outside the three-point arc.
Hughes strong to the basket, and that is his first bucket of the second half. He has 20. Could you imagine if Patrick Ewing, Dikembe Mutombo, and Alonzo Mourning were coming out of high school now, what kind of game they would have?
They'd be perimeter oriented. I was talking to Alonzo about that, is that you wouldn't dominate on the post because at the ages of 11, 12, 13, 14, you're getting taught, as you see Bayheim, you're getting taught to be able as a post player to step out in the pick and roll, knock down a 15-foot jump shot, you knock down, you know, three-point jump shot. That's not to say that you can't post up, but the name of the game is space now. They'll be totally different players.
McClung, Delina.
Again, offensive rebound.
Blair, who's been hot, leaves it. Up and in. Terrific job by Omer Yerseven, who has 9 points now. Georgetown takes a 74-62 lead, closing it on 6 minutes to go. And a travel. C.D. Bay, 10 turnovers for Syracuse.
Hey, I know we've been harping on this a little bit, but look at the defense here. Three guys around Yerseven in that zone defense. That means that on the opposite side of the court, you're not going to have a lot, but that pass came right back out to the perimeter. And Gerard, I think, got turned around and wasn't able to find Blair, and Blair made him pay.
With 7, 9 points, 9 rebounds, closing in on a double-double. Mosley, quick release in the corner, short. Dolaje with a rebound. Now Hughes, got to get cooking. Batted around and picked up. Mosley. They'll make that Blair on the baseline.
I tell you what, this Georgetown defense, you talk about adjustments, they haven't allowed Elijah Hughes to kind of get to his comfort zone, comfort spots on the court, and a lot of his shots now are more contested than we saw in the first half. So that's the kind of adjustments you make at halftime when you know a guy like Hughes can light you up.
Dolaje called for his fourth. Georgetown, gritty performance so far for Patrick Ewing's Hoyas. Ball knocked away, picked up.
Now McClung with 9 to shoot, cross court Blair. With 7, jump hook, no, but a 5.
I know Yurt Seven missed that shot, but he seems to always be in the right place at the right time. And by him playing on the baseline, Gus, and being patient, he steps right into the middle of the lane. He's a great bailout option. KYG, man, know your game.
Yurt Seven coming off a 19-point effort against SMU on Saturday. He was 8 of 12 from the field, finished with 8 rebounds in 29 minutes. A statement against Duke, your 7th at Madison Square Garden. And he scored all 21 points in the second half and grabbed 5 rebounds, had 4 block shots. Patrick Ewing loves the way this young man is playing.
And your 7th talked about why he came to Georgetown is because he wanted to learn from the best in regards to how to be a post player. Yeah, because he shot the ball again after he missed the first free throw attempt.
Wanted to get a feel.
He got a feel.
He has 10 points. Bayhan, double team. Dolezé, dribble handoff. Bayhan. Beautiful release. 14 now for Buddy Bayhan. He was scoreless in the first half. 4:43 to go, second half. Buddy Bayhan in the building. Great names have played for these two teams. Pearl Washington, Lawrence Poetry and Moat, Reggie Williams. Reggie Williams out of Dunbar High School in Baltimore. As a matter of fact, I read a great book by an author by the name of Alejandro Ganois called The Boys of Dunbar. Yeah. Did you see that?
Yes, he sent me a copy.
Man.
Unbelievable.
Bob Wade and what he did with that Dunbar program as the crack epidemic hit Baltimore. He galvanized those guys, Reggie Lewis, Muggsy Bogues, David Wingate, Reggie Williams. In the midst of all that.
In the midst of it. Father figure. He understood that he could use basketball as a tool for these young men to have options after high school that normally wouldn't be there. And that's the beauty about sports. And that's why a lot of these coaches we see is more than just about the game of basketball. It's about maturing young men at an early age.
My first job in Waco, Texas, I ended up playing some pickup basketball with a legend from Baltimore. His name was the Count. Baseline Blair. For those of you from Baltimore that remembered him.
What was his thing? What was the Count's thing? Every legend has something. What was his thing?
I played with him one time.
Okay.
And it looked back then like he could do everything. This was 1990. Inside Dolezé. Bumping and grinding now. And throws it out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a tough pass because TD Bay is usually looking up. And once you drop that pass down low, if it doesn't take that bounce to come up above the knees, it's a lot tougher for a post player on the move to be able to catch Gavin.
That's called a Reggie Theus pass. Throw it at his feet because he's got to give it back.
or he didn't want his partner to shoot it. And you know, Reggie does a couple things. I just saw him the other day. He can't count in golf either.
Oh, he cannot. But I tell you what, Homer, your 7 can count. Make it 12. 12 points. Bayhan. Another jumper goes down for Buddy Bayhan. He has 17 now. 3:46 and counting. And a timeout called by the Hoyas. .345 to play. Syracuse, they're still in this one. See if they can make a run when we come back.
The afternoon, Georgetown offense has been the three-point shot, 11 for 25 from behind the arc. Think about this, 17 assists right now, so spreading the wealth around is this Georgetown team. The ability to stretch the defense, step in, passes on time, on target, allow for an efficient offense, and those 11 three-point shots is what propelled Georgetown to this lead. Going to see if they can keep it going.
All right, we just talked to Mike Stevens, and Syracuse player we don't know and has been ejected from this game. He's been thrown out. He tripped a Georgetown player. He was a bench player. I'm not sure who he is. The officials did not give us a number.
Well, remember, go back to the first half. The bench received a technical foul as well before, so it had an impact on the game negatively for the Orange.
Right now, Buddy Boeheim with another monster second half. As a matter of fact, he's got 37 points in the last two second halves. And according to my sources, Buddy Boeheim not only got his looks, but his talent from his mama.
I'm sure she will agree. Number five from Syracuse is the one that got ejected. He's on the bench, which is Jalen Carey.
So the Hoyas with the basketball, 3:45 away from their seventh win of the season. And Patrick Ewing told us before the game, this is a huge one. He needs this one desperately. Allen fouled as he crosses the midcourt line.
Well, you take right here is what happened. You see Allen is there on the bench, falls into it. See the foot come out right in here. It's a trip right there. tried to be slick with a guy caught parking.
Yeah, that's what happened in the Michigan-Ohio State game when they tried to untie J.K. Dobbins'
shoe
during the game. And the way J.K. was running, he didn't need two shoes.
See, we at Ohio State, we don't do things like that.
Yeah, I know.
You know,
right. You don't have to. You got Chase Young.
Yep.
Boeheim driving this time. Inside the leader. Off the window, no. Dolezal with a rebound. Hughes wide open three. He pushed it.
He did. And that time Hughes probably found himself open, so anxious to get the shot up. His legs weren't even squared up on that shot. Took a little off of it. Tell you what, we got a few minutes. I got to give a shout out to two of my partners.
Who's that?
Billy Owens. I know he's watching the game. Came out a year ahead of me and my man DC, Derek Coleman.
McClung, nice look. You're seven and one. So you're seven with 14 points. And Georgetown takes a 79-68 lead.
Phenomenal job of being patient against the press. And how you beat the press via the pass right here. Never touch the ground, Gus. But up over the top, right into the middle. Then make a play. You're seven, able to get to the line. Three-point play the old-fashioned way.
Your seven has scored the last 8 points for the Hoyas, who take an 80-68 lead with 3:10 left. Boeheim on a handoff and a whistle. Now coming up against the Hoyas. So you said Billy Owens.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, so you have actually two friends from Detroit.
I got more than two. I spent a lot of time playing basketball
Derek
in high school.
Else?
C. Webb, Jalen,
okay.
Howard Isley,
okay.
Doug Smith,
okay.
Scotty, my boy. I'm gonna slide you in there too.
Don't worry about it. No, I'm about to talk to DC about this.
No, it's all right.
Here's Hughes. And he scores some shots. Lost all the rhythm he had in that first half.
Yeah.
He's 1-for-5 in the second half. Fans getting on their feet. They smell victory. Nice look. You're 7 with a jump. 17 points for the big fella. Had 3 at the break. 82-68.
The passing has been superb. Think about this. This Georgetown team, when they pass the ball, they can operate with the best of anybody.
You surprised that they're able to play this well, missing four of their key players?
Addition by subtraction. Everybody now is locked and loaded in on what they have to do, kind of galvanize the team to say, in order for us to move forward, each of us have to do a little bit more. But as a player, Gus, you're more comfortable now because you know you're playing. You know
your
minutes.
Not coming out.
And you're not, you don't have to look over your shoulder. Not that that was the case before. But this team is playing on a much higher level right now. And here's the play. He went out of Gerard right there.
Big first half for Mac McClung, 21 points. Now McClung picked up the personal and technical foul. Gerard. Gerard with 15. Make it 16.
Talking about Georgetown doing an excellent job. Only 10 turnovers this afternoon for a team that has had problems in the past of handling the basketball and taking care of it. On that season, they averaged 16. But when you take care of the ball, you allow your offense to have opportunities to be successful, and they've done that this afternoon.
Both teams with two timeouts left. Behind to the hole, left hand off the glass, softly and in. What a second half, buddy. 19 all coming in the second half.
And they probably could have needed that a little bit earlier to knock that deficit down before going in the half. But again, this Syracuse team will grow from this and be a lot better as the season goes on.
Pickett the kick. Georgetown will pull it back with a new shot clock and 2 minutes to go, leading at 82-72. Syracuse, do they need to come out of that zone?
That's not going to happen. That's not going to happen. Oh.
We're seven again, this time for Mac McClung.
Stir it up, baby. Keep it simple. Be effective. Make the plays when they're there. And that's what Georgetown has been doing all afternoon.
1:33 to go. Gerard driving, stripped. Allen got a hand on it. And Georgetown in no rush now. With seven with the last 12 points for the Hoyas. Let's see if they keep feeding him. As Pickett throws it out of bounds.
Again, execution versus the zone. McClung inside. Excellent passer. George Seven, I'm telling you, his knowledge of how to stay wide until the last minute to receive the pass is what's allowed him to be effective inside.
Bayheim off the mark. Batted around. He'll pick it back up. Reload. And hit. That turnover by Pickett infuriated Patrick Ewing. They didn't milk the clock, turned it over. Bayheim makes him pay with the three. Georgetown not out of the clear.
I tell you what, it's good to be the coach's son. Second half, Buddy Bayheim, 8 for 12, 6 from 9 from behind the arc. Could have used this a little bit earlier in the game, but you see what kind of presence he can have on the court when he's stretching the defense. His ability to knock down long-range shots gives this Syracuse offense a potent weapon. But again, started off slow in the first half.
Tell you what, though, he can get it cooking as you take a look at the game reset. Syracuse with one timeout, Georgetown with two, the arrow favoring the orange.
You know,
have you had a chance to call a game at the Carrier Dome?
No, I wish I could.
It's one of the most special experiences, especially when Syracuse is playing well.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's funny. I have some VHS tapes at home still of like the 86, 87 Big East tournament. Because I love to watch it so much, and I still have them.
Allen fouled by Gerard, bringing it up the floor. So 58.7 to go. Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule for the Hoyas. They'll play UMBC, that's University of Maryland, Baltimore County, Samford, and American before Big East play begins. At Providence, Hoyas picked to finish sixth in the Big East Conference this year. Allen at the line, he's 5 of 7. But what you do is when you go to Syracuse, you go into a game the night before, you got to go to a place called Grimaldi's.
pizza. Italian.
No, it's a steakhouse.
Oh, steakhouse.
One of the best steaks you'll ever eat in your life. Grimaldi.
22-ounce bone-in.
And then during the day, sometimes you go to 44. It's right on campus in the main drag. And then you got to add a little dinosaur barbecue. And then you'll be complete.
All right.
Allen with 13 points. Bayham shows it. Three-pointer. Boom.
Woo!
Stroking. He's got 25.
And Georgetown has to be careful to get the ball inbound. Secure it here. Can't turn it over.
Allen fouled again in the backcourt. Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule for Coach Boeheim's Orange. Oakland, North Florida, Niagara. In ACC play with Notre Dame and Virginia Tech.
Yeah, when we take a look at this schedule, and also Dolezal fouled out, but interesting. Georgetown's schedule, those first three games, or the next three games, if they can finish this one off, are so important from a mental aspect. Because you've been rolling. If you win this game, that's three in a row. Now you're playing opponents that you should win. Where is the concentration and focus on those games before you start Big East play? That's why I think those three games are very important for this Georgetown team.
Georgetown 22 of 28 from the line, shooting free throws well. Second free throw no good for Allen. 45 seconds to play. Hughes wants it, breaks to the ball, gathers it, drives to the hole, hangs in the air, draws a foul.
I know that's one thing that Coach Ewing did not want. He wanted to contest the shot, but the foul here stops the clock. Hughes is able to knock in the free throws. Now Syracuse has a chance to set up their defense. And that time, good seven could have just kind of went straight up in the air.
Patrick Ewing. Been working hard on his Peloton bike. He's lost some LBs. As Hughes makes the first. I got a Peloton bike, Jimmy.
To what?
I have a Peloton bike.
No, but you said it's the best coat hanger you ever had.
It certainly is.
That's a bird on the street, you know?
Yeah. You are correct, sir. In the front court, McClung. Repeat it back, try to work the clock. And foul.
And see, that's the maturity right there, guys. Of understanding time and score, that it's not as important to take that shot as it is to run down the clock.
And Buddy Boeheim is fouled out with 25 points. Last 2 weeks been very tough for Georgetown. Four players leaving the program for various reasons. This team, though, showing the heart and grit of their legendary coach and ultimate warrior, Patrick Ewing. He can unbutton the tie now. He can loosen it up a little bit. The Beast. That's his nickname, folks. They used to call Patrick the Beast or Beast.
Hey, I'm used to hearing him yell because he was an assistant coach on the Houston Rockets staff under Jeff Van Gundy when I was there. And what a great time I had learning and just spending time talking to Patrick.
Washington on the baseline. No. McClung with the rebound. Brings it into the front court. And they'll just pull it back. How about this, Georgetown? Battling through adversity over the last couple of weeks, and they'll knock off their longtime rival, Syracuse, 89-79 the final. McClung with 26 points. Yurt 7, 19 points. Buddy Boeheim had 25 for the Orange. And Hughes finishes with 21. Georgetown 7-3 now. Syracuse 5-5. 89-79 the final. Coming up next on Fox, it's Run It Back. Jermell Charlo versus Tony Harrison, followed by Fox Inside PBC Boxing. For Jim Jackson and Andy Katz, I'm Gus Johnson saying so long from the nation's capital. You've been watching College Hoops on FOX.